did that little whippersnapper go? No, there he is. Guy! Guy! Here's Guy!
All my life, when people said, what do you do? And I said, I'm a photographer. I could tell by the look on their face that they thought, oh yeah, sure you are. Do you know they wouldn't have thought that? Oh, this is going to make me cry. You know they wouldn't have thought that if you were a guy. I think about that a lot. As long as I can remember, I've said I'm a photographer, because that's the only job I've ever had. People just want a one-word answer, you know? They don't want, oh, I'm a photographer, I'm a therapist, I'm a shepherdess. I say I'm a photographer because... I grew up on a farm. I just always felt more comfortable with some space and the animals. I was sort of determined to get a farm again. And then this came up, and so I moved here. I brought this out so you can carve your name. Hey, Sky, down. When I started taking pictures, I was little. I was like 9 or 10 or something. And I had this little camera. My mom must have given it to me or something. There wasn't any picture taking after that. It was just me. And I just wanted to record everything that was going on. I mean, I was a little obsessed with it. As a little girl back in the 50s, I didn't know any women photographers. I mean, the only women I knew that worked were teachers, flight attendants, wives. I always thought that I would have to be doing something else. I remember my dad said to me, are you kidding me? I mean, you're an artist, Nina. And I was like, wow, really? I get to do that? I said, but when I get out, you know, I wouldn't be able to make any money doing anything. And he said, don't worry about that. Just do what you do. And then when I got out of school, I just started taking pictures and working for newspapers and taking pictures and taking pictures and never stopped. Only a few more pictures before all that wool goes away. You ready, Dodgy? You're the cutest little sheep. It looks like a mythical creature. Just like you drew this crazy looking animal. About 8 or 9 years ago, somebody wanted to raise sheep and they wanted to raise them here. And I didn't know anything about sheep. And I was like, there's no way. It just seemed nutty to me. It was a really warm February. The person came to me and they said, this farmer's getting divorced and he has these 12 sheep. Can I bring them over there? And I'm like, all right. Bring the sheep over. So he came over with these 12 sheep. 9 of them were pregnant, and 2 weeks later they started having babies. But right away I started photographing them. And I was just mesmerized by the way they look. Well, you see the way they look at you and they recognize you. You know, they recognize faces. People think they're stupid. I don't think they're stupid at all. I think they're beautiful with those horns and their mothering instincts. They're great mothers. The mother and the baby and what goes on between them is just so amazing.
Beautiful baby. You want to give me my baby back.
Also, I needed to keep a record of what was going on, and that was the easiest way for me to do it, is to photograph the moms. I would print them out and put them in a book and say, this mom on this date had this baby. photographing my own world, and so I'm very much a part of that world. And I'm also out there feeding them, cleaning the barn. I spend a lot of time looking at them. You're always looking to see if they're healthy and who's somebody's limping, and very involved in them. When I'm photographing them, I'm stepping out for a moment, and then I'm stepping back in. When the guy said he was bringing over the sheep, I didn't even say what kind of sheep, because I knew nothing, zero. I called a lot of sheep people, and I had people come over, and I called every person I knew that might know who had sheep. I had to ask for a lot of help. I had to scream, help, help me, help me. There was so many times in the beginning, and I had all these sheep, and I was like, I really need a dog. I didn't know anything about border collies, about training them. How do they do that? It's amazing to me to watch them do that. It's been a journey. I think that there's such beauty in the world, and that most people don't see it. And I felt like this when I was little, with taking those little pictures and then showing them to my family. It's like, see what's out there? This is out there, and you walk right by it. So I would think that the common thread would hopefully be of some interest to the viewer, so that the viewer would stop for a second. I think I need to own it by taking a picture of it. Time keeps going on, but I've stopped a little bit of time, and I have it. I think that's why I do it, and when I did it when I was really little, because I just wanted it to stop. And the older you get, you know, the faster the time goes. It's crazy. I'm probably taking more photographs now than I ever have. When I bought this farm, I did not say, oh, I think I'll move to a farm, then I'll go back to school and get my master's. And in the middle of getting my master's, I'll get some sheep. And then I'll start photographing the sheep, and then that's what I'll do. I'll buy a farm. You know, I didn't do that. I didn't even think of that. So, I mean, I can't, when people say, what are you gonna be doing 5 years from now, 10 years from now, it's like, I don't know. I have no idea. I think that's a good thing. Yeah.